Hi there. Today I am going to be drawing you with makeup. So just have a seat, lie down, sit comfortably, and enjoy your session. Makeup when you do it on a surface like this. You really don't need that much, so I'm going to get a dash of it. And I'll show you how it looks at the end, the result. But on paper, actually, I guess I do need a lot more than that. Because the paper absorbs it. It doesn't spread out like the skin does. You can blend it with the skin, but I guess the foundation makes it difficult. So I'm gonna put more than I think I'm gonna be wasting, like half my foundation bottle just for this. Thank you. This definitely reminds me of the days when we would use watercolors and paint in school. Brings some slightly fond memories of those times in my life. I'm just doing a face. I'm not doing hair. See how well I can do this. Not bad. Thank you. Honestly, this is not that bad. I thought it would have been worse. I'm gonna do the bronzer next. To kind of get it flowing evenly on the page. Contour. See how well I can manage to do this. Getting some kind of gender neutral energy, maybe one mini five more. Been trying to make it more neutral. Just a little contouring. Let's do a little for the nose now, actually. Because you want to have a nose. Begin forming the sort of shape. It's a bit tricky. On paper, you really want to blend it hard. Okay, I think that's enough. I did probably a bit. I will move on to the blush, because you gotta be blushing if you want to look good. Let's see, what should I do? I'll do a dark kind of rosy peachy color, and I'll just put it on the apples of the cheeks and blend it in. Just use that to blend. blending in the brows with the finger. That's a big reason why I started the eyebrows and then the lips, so that I can really get a sense of the nose shape and the hue, the identity of the individual I am working on now. I'm actually gonna blend the brow again with this brush. I'm just kind of working back and forth, gradually filling in colors as I go. This piece overall looks amazing. I think a nice blend of colors works best than just doing straight up black, so it gives it more life. It inspires the picture, the portrait. I mean, I'm not going to lie. This is actually looking really nice. It creates even more three-dimension when you add sparkly, glittery things. I think that works out nicely. Ooh, I can even add it under the brows to really get that. And above, even get the contrast flowing. There we go. Oh, that came out so wonderfully. Maybe over the lip even. Okay. I'll start working on the eyes, and if I feel like I need improvement anywhere else, I will just continue, but I do want a base color for the eyes. I will put the whites first with this larger brush and continue from there. Yeah. And I will begin outlining the inner color. We'll go with a dark blue. I'm just feeling a blue right now for some reason. The white seems to soften the color, but that's fine since this is a very gentle picture anyway. Nothing is too sticking out too much, I guess. Just the lips and the brows, really. Okay. You have to be very, very precise and very careful, so I'm just putting all my attention on this picture at this time. Blowing away the residue. Again, really trying to leave that impression. To use different techniques on paper versus on the actual human face. We're gonna get the tiny hint of a black color for the pupil. I will squeeze this brush and form a tip. Just do the eyeshadow and then be done. What else? I don't think there's much else I can do, to be honest. I wanted to add a little bit of a glittery color, like a red. But I fear I would be regretting this decision. Actually, and not so much a challenge, it just kind of flowed. I'm getting a vibe of like a farm girl in like the 15th century or something like that. That's my first impression. Anyway, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And what do you think? Let me know. I'd love to do a video, like I said, just showing you how to do this, I guess. It's just like a face and nothing else. That's all I wanted to do, so I think